Welcome back to some more derivatives involving the natural log function. Here we have f of x equals 5 times natural log x cubed. So notice how we have a composite function, so we'll let u equal the inner function of x cubed. So now we'll need du dx or u prime, which will be 3x squared. So now we can rewrite this function as 5 natural log u. Therefore, f prime of x is going to be equal to 5 times the derivative of natural log u, which is given here below. With the chain rule, we'll have 1 over u times u prime. So we'll have 1 over x cubed times u prime, which is 3x squared. So I'll write 3x squared over 1. Now let's go ahead and simplify this. Notice two factors of x simplify out. This simplifies to 1, this simplifies to x to the first. This 5 would also be over 1. So our derivative function is equal to, looks like we have 15 divided by x. Now I do want to show this problem one more time using a slightly different method. If we have f of x equals 5 natural log x cubed, if we wanted to, we could apply the power property of logarithms given here to the initial function, which means we can move this exponent of 3 to the front. So f of x is equal to 15 natural log x. And in this form, we don't have to apply the chain rule because we just have the function natural log x. If we did to apply the chain rule, that's okay. U would be equal to x and u prime would be equal to 1. So in this form, f prime of x is just going to be equal to 15 times the derivative of natural log x, which is 1 over x, or 1 divided by x. So our derivative function is 15 divided by x. So as you can see, if we apply a log property to the initial function, it's not going to change our derivative.